please welcome Lee Brimlow with Project Clean Take.
Thank you.
Hello.
Hello.
Hi, Lee.
How you doing?
Fine, how are you?
Good.
Congratulations on today. I'm excited
to see
this.
Oh, thank you.
And you're gonna wreck it.
Nice.
Somebody call Ralph, because you're gonna wreck it.
So we do a lot of video production at Adobe. Sorry, I got a lot to go through.
Got him.
Yeah. But so we do a lot of video production, and I got asked to help to put together this video about the Adobe Seattle office. And after we shot the footage, there were numerous issues with the dialogue and audio. And that takes a whole nother level of knowledge that I don't have. So that's where Project Clean Take comes in. So this is an interview with my coworker, Caroline. Let me just play a second.
Hi, I'm Caroline Colon. I'm a user researcher in my fifth year at Adobe.
So after she watched the footage, there were a couple of things that she wishes she could change. So one of the things was the way she said, at Adobe. So that's known as an uptalk, where the inflection goes up at the end and it sounds like a question. So traditionally, the only way to fix something like that would be to reshoot it. But now we can just go to the transcript panel, and I can just choose at Adobe, and then select regenerate spoken
words. You're
gonna
make her un-Wisconsinite?
Yeah, exactly. So let's give that a listen.
Hello, I'm a user researcher in my fifth year at Adobe.
Wow!
I first moved to Seattle in 2016.
Okay, look at him.
Oh, there's
He's
more.
He's so used to it. He's so used to it. You're not even pausing for the, he's like, I'm not playing with y'all today. We got a lot to get through today.
Yeah.
He does have a lot.
Okay, yep. Keep going.
All right.
That was amazing.
So the next issue was, she said my fifth year at Adobe, but it's actually her fourth year. So for that, I could just select the word fifth and choose replace spoken words. And then I can just change it to fourth.
No, you can't.
And hit replace.
No,
oh, yes.
You can't.
Yes.
No, you can't.
All right.
No, you can't. And I better not see it.
All right, let's just give it a listen.
Caroline Colon. I'm a user researcher in my fourth year at Adobe.
Oh! Yeah.
Lee.
It happened.
Do you know how much time that's going to save for actors?
I hope so.
I'm going to learn half my lines now. And I'm going to call you and ask you to fill in the rest. This is crazy.
We can do it.
So crazy.
This next clip was an interview with my coworker, Matt.
Mm-hmm.
He was speaking outside of the Adobe Seattle office in front of the Fremont Bridge. And let me just play a few seconds.
We're in the Fremont neighborhood of Seattle, where the Adobe office is located. And the cool thing about this office is where it's located.
So you can obviously...
Who is that?
You can obviously hear that bell. That's because this bridge is a drawbridge that was actually opening while he was talking about it, which was great that it happened to open when he was talking about it, but obviously that sound is way too loud and jarring.
Mm-hmm.
So what we can do using our new and updated source separation technology is to take the audio from the video and break it up into its individual components directly in the timeline.
No way.
So it's broken it up into speech, ambience, sound effects, music, and reverb. Well, that bell ringing was actually on the sound effects track, so I can just mute it.
This is located. And the cool thing about this office is where it's located.
No way!
It's between Lake Union and the Fremont Bridge behind me. Lake Union is...
He's not even looking at y'all right now. He's so locked in. You're in flow state for this, and I see it.
Or if you want, because it is kind of part of the bridge.
Active airport, so you can see float planes take on and off all day from
you can
it.
Just lower
right
the
overhead. And behind me, so you can see that the Fremont Bridge is.
He's like, don't clap for me.
No, please clap. Please clap. So this next video we shot in the Adobe gym.
Wellness center, this is the performance center of the office. Whatever you need to get your mind.
So the audio sounds good. There's some like nice ambience of people lifting weights, but we had an issue towards the end.
Training, group exercise classes. Come by and join us.
So again, somebody had dropped a barbell at that moment, which is obviously way too jarring. So I can go back to my individual stems here, but I don't want to just mute the sound effects track because there's other things on that track that I want. So what we can do instead is to do a range selection on just that part and choose to mute that part of the sound effects track.
Personal training, group exercise classes, come by and join us.
So that has been removed now.
Wow.
So the next issue is a very common one when you're shooting in public places. So, and that's, there's music playing in the background that you don't have the license to. This could be at a sporting event, a crowded market. So we could just mute the music on this. Let me just solo it real quick. So I don't have the license for that. So I could mute it, but we have another option, which is to come here and choose Find Similar.
What?
So this will take that music and look for a matching piece of music on Adobe stock and replace it in the video track.
No way.
So let's listen real quick. So that sounds good, but it doesn't sound like it's actually playing in the gym. It just sounds like I added it during editing. So we can take a further step, which is to match the acoustic properties of the original music.
Hey.
So cool.
Don't you do it.
No, I have to.
Don't you do it.
So that's a little loud. Let me just lower the volume
that's
of it. Let me unsolo that.
Don't do it.
And just lower it.
Performance center of the office. Whatever you need to get your mind and body right.
Kind of hard to hear, but it basically sounds just like the original.
That's amazing.
All right, so this last example, I was asked at the last minute to record a voiceover for the intro. And this is what I did.
Just north of downtown in the eclectic Fremont neighborhood, you'll find Adobe Seattle campus.
So the feedback I got from that was, hey, you sounded kind of bored and uninterested, which was pretty accurate because—
You could have added a little more. Like, you could have added a little, put this, some sauce on it.
This project had gone way too long, but so I really didn't want to have to re-record this. So what we can do is go back to the transcript and I can just select all of it and we can change the emotion of my voiceover.
You know you can't.
Oh yeah.
No you can't.
So I'm gonna change it to confident.
Oh, you were already confident in it.
Oh, thank you.
He confidently didn't want to do it.
Just north of downtown in the eclectic Fremont neighborhood, you'll find Adobe Seattle campus.
So.
It's funny you didn't want to do it, and then you didn't want to re-record it, so you had technology to do it for you.
So that sounds good. It's probably a little too confident. I kind of sound like a PM, you know, but. No, we love our PMs. We love
What's
them.
A PM?
Product manager. Product manager.
Oh, roasted. A little insider baseball, but we'll allow
So this is a really fun technology to play with, so I'll just do one more.
Okay.
So we can change this to a whisper.
He's a yin-yang twin.
Just north of downtown, in the eclectic Fremont neighborhood, you'll find Adobe Seattle campus.
That's it?
That was awesome.
Thank you.
Great.
Thank you.
Labor and love. Well done.
That was like five sneaks in one, I feel.
Yeah.
Yeah. No, how long were you working on that?
Probably 6 months.
Wow.
Yeah.
That's also not. Doesn't seem
well, there was a huge team of other people.
I bet.
You don't have to talk about them.
Yeah.
That's amazing. Congratulations. Yeah. That's so cool.
Thank you.
Thanks for letting me talk. Thank you.
You're the man.
Thank you.